Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. If you want to see my upcoming new tutorials, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. This is the fourth episode to create photography website using Flexbox. In the previous episode, we worked on the hero section. Today, we'll work on image gallery. So first, open your text editor and open index.html and main.css. Just after this hero block, add the comment called gallery block and add section with a class called gallery block. If you check the design, we have got same title in different section. So we will use block class name so that we can reuse in the future. Then currently our content is at middle, so we will reuse div with a class called container. And for title, we will use s2 tag, and our title is gallery. Now let's add all of this image inside div with a class called col. But before that, let's add div with a class called row. This will be the parent element, and also in the future in CSS we will add display flex in this row class name. For each image, let's use div class col, and for image, let's add image tag. Our image is under images folder, and I want to use img1.jpg image. In all tag, let's just use img1. Now we need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 different images. So copy this col div name and paste it 8 more times. Then you can simply rename this image to img2.jpg, img2, img3.jpg, img3, and so on. img8.jpg, img8, and finally img9.jpg and img9. You can then refresh the site, and our HTML is ready. Now let's work on the CSS. If you look at the design, we got same padding top and bottom across each section. So to reuse them in the future, we will style them in block class name. So let's add block comment, block class name, and add padding top and bottom of 70px. We also need the border bottom as well, so apply border bottom 1px solid E6, E6, E6. Refresh the site, and we can see equal padding top and bottom for every section. Now style this title. Again, we got same title for each section, so to reuse them, we will apply in block class name. I want bigger font size, so let's apply font size of 30px, padding 00 10px, margin 00 40px, and to keep them at center, let's use text align center, refresh the site. It is now looking somehow similar, except we are missing the border at the bottom. Remember, we have small border, so we can't use border bottom and text decoration underline. Instead, we have to use after pseudo element to resolve that. We need blank content whenever we use pseudo element. Add the black background. And to achieve that border, we need width and height. So let's add width 60px and height 1px. Add position absolute and bottom 0. To keep it at the center, we need left 50% and transform translate x negative 50%. Refresh the site. And now we can see small border at the very bottom. Remember, we have used position absolute, so we need to add position relative in s2 tag. Refresh, and now our title is looking exactly the same. Great. Now let's work on this image gallery. We have to keep all images side by side. So in row class name, we have to add display flex. We want to reuse them again, so let's add block class name as well. Refresh the site. And now we can see all images in one row. We just need to show 3 images in one row. So in cool class name, let's add flex basis 33.33%. Also in parent element, we have to add flex wrap. Refresh the site now. And now we can see 3 images in each row. Now let's add padding left, right, and bottom. So in this cool class name, add padding top to 0, left right to 15px, and bottom to 30px. Whenever we use padding in child element, we need to use negative margin in parent element. So let's use 0 and minus 15px. Refresh the site, and now it is looking somehow similar. Now, let's apply fixed height for all images only for this image gallery. So let's add comment called gallery block. Then let's add gallery block class name and cool class name. Apply fixed height of 370px. Refresh the site. And now, the height of the image is not increased according to its container. So to resolve that, in the image tag, let's apply object fit cover. Let's also apply height 100%. Refresh the site now. Now if you compare to our design, it is looking exactly the same. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll work on the latest post section. Feel free to comment below if you have any question. Also please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. If you want some hosting companies, you can check the link in the description below. Thank you and see you soon.